said that a 7-year-old boy had done it, so he said, you have to do it. So he said that you have to focus better. So this time I again tried. Again it hurt me, it didn't rain. But somewhere the pain became lesser. And I could feel it. So I told him that this time I felt that my pain got lesser than before. So now what is happening, I was focusing better. I was getting in the zone, I was getting in the moment. Before what was happening, when he showed me the pencil, most of the time I'm not in the present. I'm always thinking and thinking about things. So it's very difficult for me to get tuned into something. So what was happening in my first trial, my mind was busy telling me, it's going to hurt, how's it possible, it will take a lot of time, what is this, you can't do it, or you know, this is so boring, this is so stupid. So my mind was busy. Now in this first bolt, pain, I got a little bit, you know, alert. So I tried again, didn't work, but my pain became lesser. So I got really excited. So the third time, he said that you have to envision it, see it the way you want to see it. You have to see it, believe it first to see it. So now I did everything. My stroke was right, my approach was right, but then, you know, he dropped the pencil. He said, sometimes circumstances are not right. I said, okay, now it's my fourth trial. And this time, and the more I'm hitting, my pain is getting lesser and lesser. Because now my focus is not there. So the fourth stroke, I've been cracked right in the center. And I didn't feel nothing at all. I didn't feel the pain. The pain that was there was from the first shot. That was, it sounds like a very simple trick, but it was such a visceral and surreal experience for me. It was, I can say it was one of the most spiritual experiences for me. Because before I was quitting my job, so that helped me a lot. Because I was taking up a lot of challenges. I was about to quit a very comfortable, cozy, well-paying job and go out on this venture of coaching and, you know, doing something on my own. So that incident gave me so much of clarity. It gave me this belief that I fully focus on something without any doubt. I can create anything. When I focus without any doubt, so if you have doubt, you can't do it. When you focus and you obsessively focus on something, on the outcome of something, you get it, nothing can stop you. That's why terrorists become successful in what they do. I give this example a lot about terrorists. We should learn from terrorists. Why are terrorists successful? Because they have clarity, they focus, they don't doubt about